Feeny, Wikipedia Audio. Feeny is a spirit produced exclusively in Goa, India. There are two types of feeny, cashew feeny and toddy palm feeny, depending on the original ingredient. The small batch distillation of feeny has a fundamental effect on its final character, still retaining some of the delicate aromatics, congeners, and flavor elements of the juice from which it was produced. Feeny is classified as a country liquor, and is therefore not allowed to be sold outside the state of Goa. The word feeny is derived from the Sanskrit word fena. This is thought to be because of the bubbles that form a light froth when the liquor is shaken in a bottle or poured into a glass. It is generally accepted that coconut feeny was produced before and then followed to adapt the same procedure for distilling the exotic cashew fruit. Coconut palms are abundant along the coastline of western India and Goa, whereas the cashew tree was an exotic species brought by the Portuguese to India. There is ambiguity about when and who started distilling fermented juice into a spirit. Preparation. The feeny consumed in South Goa is generally of a higher alcohol content as compared to the feeny produced in North Goa. Commercially packaged feeny is available at 42.8% ABV. In the traditional method of making cashew feeny, only tree-ripened cashew apples that have fallen are picked and taken for the crush. The cashew apples are deseeded and then dropped into the stomping area. This area is called a kalmbai and is usually a rock cut into a basin shape. The cashew apples are stomped to release the juice. Stomping has now gradually been replaced by the use of a press called a pingra. The pulp is then hand-pattied into small mounds, traditionally using a particular vine, nudi, which is snaked around it to hold it together while a heavy weight is placed on top. The juice produced through this process is known as niro, and is refreshing to drink. The fresh niro is traditionally in a large earthen pot called a kadem, which is buried halfway in the ground and left while the juice ferments for several days. Delicate earthen kadem have now been replaced by plastic drums for the sake of practicality. The juice is then allowed to sit for 3 days as it ferments. No artificial yeast or nutrients are added to hasten the process. Cashew feeny is distilled employing the traditional pot, which is still practiced. A traditional distilling feeny is still known as a bati. The use of an earthen pot as the boiling pot has now been replaced with copper pots, both known by the same name ban. The distillate is collected in an earthen pot called a lani. The tradition of cold water being continuously poured on the lani to condense the distillate has now been replaced by immersing a coil in cold water. Cashew feeny is a triple distilled spirit. The first distillate of the fermented niro is known as arak, about 15% alcohol. Arak is then mixed with niro in a proportion determined by the distiller, and redistilled to give a spirit called cajolo or cajolo. Cajolo or cajolo is again distilled with arak to give a high-strength spirit called feeny. Note that cajolo is generally sold as feeny, as the spirit is considered too strong of an alcoholic beverage for consumption. All cashew feeny now available is double distilled. Coconut feeny is distilled from fermented toddy from the coconut palm. Traditionally, toddy is collected from the coconut palm by a toddy tapper called a rendier. Toddy tapping, the collection of juice from the bud or spadix of palm tree flowers, has been practiced in the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia for centuries. The sap of the coconut palm is collected in an earthen pot called zamino or daminum, which is fitted over the spadix that grows out of the base of each coconut leaf. In order to produce toddy, The spadix is tightly bound with a rope made from filaments cut with a small knife from the base of the leaf, while remaining attached to the pedicle. The spadix then must be tapped all around very gently with the handle of the kathi every alternate day until it becomes round and flexible, a sign that the sap is ready. The tip of the spadix is then cut off to let the sap ooze out into the damanum. Toddy is collected from the damanum in the morning and evening, and then carried down the tree in a gourd-shaped container called dudhinam before being poured into a clay pot called kalso. The spadix is sharpened at noon by slicing a small piece horizontally off the top, called cho, so as to reactivate the flow of sap. For 3 days the toddy used to be left to ferment in clay or porcelain pots, called mon or yahalo. Coconut feni is largely produced and consumed only in South Goa. It is distilled employing the traditional pot. Coconut feni is prepared in a distillery known as a Sorachi Bati. The use of an earthen pot as the boiling pot has now been replaced with copper pots, both known by the same name ban. The mouth of the ban is sealed with a wooden stopper called Muranem. The vapors from the ban passed through a tube called Nolo, made from a bonki stem, and collected in a clay distillation pot called Lani, which was placed in an open clay vessel called Kadem filled with water. The copper coil is immersed in cold water to condense the vapors. Commercially bottled coconut feni has a strength of 42.8% ABV. Coconut feni is a double distilled spirit. The first distillate is called a malup, about 15% alcohol. 4 kalshis of toddy produce 2 pots of malup. 4 pots of malup are then mixed with 1 kalso of toddy, which is added to distill what is then a fiery coconut feni. The feni selling market is largely unorganized. Locals tend to buy feni directly from the thousands of traditional distillers who run seasonal mini distilleries or stalls in the villages of Goa. A large volume of feni that is distilled is sold directly by distillers to taverns who have business relationships that extend over generations. Cashew feni. Cashew feni is seasonal, distilled only from late February to mid-May. It is highly dependent on the fruiting of the season. The price of cashew feni is also speculated on the fruiting season. Coconut feni is produced throughout the year as coconut trees are tapped year-round. During the monsoon months, the coconut palms produce more toddy than the drier months. Toddy tapping is very labor-intensive and so is not an appealing profession. This has led to the dramatic decline in production of coconut feni. In the organized sector, there are also hundreds of brands to choose from that cater to the tourist market. Locals have slowly begun to switch to standardized bottled feni in recent years. Feni can be served neat or over ice, and can be mixed in classic cocktails or with juices. It can be served with a slice of lime, and sometimes with sugar or sugar syrup, which are popular additions. Popular mixers are cola, tonic water, and lemonade, with the latter probably the most popular. Feni is also often mixed with limca, Sprite, or 7-Up. Cashew feni was awarded geographical indication registration in 2009 as a speciality alcoholic beverage from Goa, described as a colorless, clear liquid that when matured in wooden barrels develops golden brown tint. This designation was achieved through the efforts of the Goa Cashew Feni Distillers and Bottlers Association and the Department of Science, Technology and Environment of the Government of Goa. The application of a GI for coconut feni has been neglected. In 2016, the Goan government initiated a process for Fini to be recognized as a heritage brew outside of the state. Goa Chief Minister Lakshmikant Parsker described Fini as part of our culture. Plans include nature tourism where tourists can see cashew harvesting and follow the process of the drink's manufacture. Several distillers urged the government to issue rules on distillation process and ensure that they are obeyed. Counterfeit Fini and adulteration in quality were some of the issues raised by participants. Coconut Fini. Commerce. Consumption. Geographical indication. Heritage drink.